Hallelujah and praise the Lord. Today is the 3rd of July 2020, and we thank the Lord for this new day and an opportunity to serve Him, to worship Him, and to live for Him. My name is Joseph Malonza. I'm coming to you from Christian Church International, Neema Machakos. It's my pleasure and delight to bring to you the Word of God today. The Bible says in Psalms 124, verse 2 to 3, "If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us," verse 3, "then they would have quickly swallowed us up alive when their wrath was kindled against us." Our topic for today is, who is on your side? Who is on your side? Ni nani aliye katika upande wa kwako? I know I'm talking to somebody who is listening to me this morning. Maybe you are married, you are a husband, you say that I have my wife by my side. You're the wife, you say that I have my husband by my side. You're there, you're a parent, you have children. The children will say, "I have dad, I have mom." The parent will say, "I have so and so. They are my children and I love them." I know we have friends. We have different types of friends. Wherever we work from, maybe where we do businesses from, we have friends. And as I've said, yeah, we have colleagues, people we work together with. You might say, "I have colleagues so and so. He will sort me out when I am in trouble, when I have problems." And I know that we've been taught, even in church, there is this series which we have been taught on responsibility in relationships. And I thank God that such a series has come at a time as this. And I bless the name of the Lord. If you've not been following us, you can search us on YouTube, on Facebook, and you see this sermon series on responsibility in relationships. That is good. You have people you are relating with. But most important, do you have God? Do you have God by your side? Do not forget that you need God by your side. Because these friends, these people we have, at some point they will say, "You know what? I'm tired. I will leave you. You know what? I'm limited. I cannot do this." But we have a God who is not limited. We have a God who has everything. Now, from where we've read in Psalms 124, this was written by David. And who was David? You know that David was the king of Israel. And he had fought many battles. The enemies of Israelites, when they rose, David led the army of Israel to fight against them. And that's why David knew that it's not about the horses that I have. It's not about the chariots that I have. But it is about God being on by my side. And that's why he confesses and says, "If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, then when all these enemies rose up against us, they would have swallowed up the whole of Israel." And right now, we won't be having Israel in the map of the world. But because God was with them, they fought the battles and they won. When you have the Lord on your side, verse 3 has told us that the enemies, they will not swallow us up. The Lord will fight for us. The enemies may seem many, but as long as the Lord of hosts is on your side, He will fight for you. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 15 to 17. The Bible says, "When the servant of the man of God got up and went out early the next morning, an army with horses and chariots had surrounded the city. 'Oh my Lord, what shall we do?' the servant asked." Verse 16, "Do not be afraid," the prophet answered. "Those who are with us are more than those who are with them." Verse 17, "And Elisha prayed, 'O Lord, open his eyes so he may see.' Then the Lord opened the servant's eyes, and he looked and saw the hills full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. As I complete this morning, I want us to have 4 points that we'll draw from where I've just read. Number one, know and understand that those who are with us are more than those against us. Number two, we are surrounded by chariots of fire. And that means that nothing that comes against us will touch us because we are surrounded by chariots of fire. That's the armies of the Lord. They are with us. Number three, greater is he who is in us than the one who is in the world. And that is according to 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4. And lastly, number four, we need spiritual eyes to be able to know what is happening around us. We don't need to move and go on blindly and fall into the hands of calamity when we have spiritual eyes. My dear listener, may the Lord bless you today, and may you desire to have the Lord on your side. When he is on your side, he will fight your battles and victory will be guaranteed. May the Lord bless you and keep you today in Jesus' name. Amen.